That was REM, Man on the Moon. It's funny about that. I never liked REM, and I still don't when I was growing up. And that I don't remember too much about it, but I don't think I cared for that movie, Man on the Moon. And I really disliked Jim Carrey, who was in that movie, Man on the Moon. And I really don't know that much about Andy Kaufman, who the song is about, as you may or may not know. But I love that song. The song's just something about that song. It's so awesome, even though I don't like any reason to like it. Anywho, so I was so with this video, I'm gonna do another video today and open up something. But this video, I am dumping all my extra cards, even the ones that I was kind of holding on to and kind of reducing what I was gonna try to go for sets. We're gonna be moving soon. So that's what I've been doing. I've been off for about a week now. Been at night, been going through cards and going through all the stuff. And I'm just going to show you the stuff that I missed before. Stuff that maybe I changed my mind on. Just stuff that I rescued out of. It's going to be 35,000 cards that I dump. So, hey, Big Son, the next time I send you a package, I got some more Cecil Fielders for you. We saw Bob the Hammer Hamlin. He's trying so hard there. I like Bob Hamlin. Okay, I didn't know that much about him, but fucking Bob Hamlin. Okay, and then anytime I used to do breaks with John at the Passes Alive, unfortunately, it just seems like I'm working now. Or the stuff that the times I possibly could do it, that's when the roommate's up. And that's when I'm spending time with the roommate. But I used to always get Bill Van Landingham cards. So I found these and made me remember all the old breaks that I used to do with John. Bill fucking Van Landingham. And then do a little arts and crafts. I want to introduce you to my new favorite player, Tint Kekulve. That is Tint Kekulve. You're welcome. I had a little arts and crafts time. So anyway, let me set this stuff to the side. Still got a lot of football sets that I may or may not try to put together to go through, and also some baseball stuff. But for the most part, the only thing that's left is possible sets. I found this in the football. This is a sleeve for 4 cents. This is a 1990 football checklist. If anybody's interested, give me a shout out, give me a ring, send me an email, and if the price is a little steep for you, maybe we could work something out. I'm willing to negotiate, be a little flexible on it. So let me just start going through the cards that I came through. Nothing spectacular here. There's only just a couple cards that I probably didn't even need to put in a top loader, but I did. Just like people that I collect, Goldschmidt. There's a bunch of Justin Verlander. There's a Mark Grace in there. There's Scherzer. There's some Miguel Cabreras. These aren't any particular order. Glavins. There's a couple, like, kind of team cards. I took out a lot of the team cards also. It's like, this is a Miguel Cabrera on the team card. Because when I do lots of players, this was the one card that I needed for my 1987 top set. And I found another one of it. So those are, I have these in a particular stack because these are the individual players that I keep. Let me go through some of the other stuff here. There's a Juan Gonzalez rookie. Just a Brandon Woodruff. It was a refractor. And then another Brandon Woodruff. And they're inserts. There's a green. A lot of these cards, like I said, if I did sell a team lot, I'm trying to sell a Brewers team lot right now. So that's one of the reasons I pulled out that. You know, you can, the more cards you add, the better. There's a possibly not his real rookie card, but Moises Alou, it says rookie on it. I have to check into that. I found a couple Vladimir Guerrero cards. And then anybody that was a rookie from recent that I missed, I take that and put that in the pile. There's a Daniel Lynch. There's a Ryan O'Hearn. There's a Salvador Perez insert. And that I consider to be Vladdy Jr. cards. And a nice Trey Turner chrome there. I didn't really collect Trey Turner at the time, but I started kind of collecting them a little bit more. So, like I said, not all these cards will end up sticking. But we'll see. Hold on real quick here. And then there's the Dansby Swanson Holiday. I'm not going to go through. There's Dansby Swanson Red. There's a Vinny Castillo rookie card. And I collect rookie cards even of guys that like weren't big superstars. Like, Vinny Castillo's okay. He was a known player. Just to have it. It's not worth anything. And then I found some Kyle Lewis's that I'll send to Stephen H. the next time I get a package to him. Luis Gonzalez gold card. There's a Bobby Abreu. Bobby Abreu, a lot of people think should be a Hall of Famer. There's his pre-rookie card. There's an Aaron Nola SP Liberty Bell. There was only one Sandberg, but it wasn't really a Sandberg. It was Sandberg sliding into the base of another player. There's a Walker, a couple Walker Buellers. I don't always keep. There's Corey Seager's. I put together a Dodgers lot. There's a Mariano Rivera. Just stuff that I maybe wasn't keeping at the time. Alex Rodriguez. There's some better stuff. I mean, not great, but I'll get there in a minute. Ozzie Smith. I don't even know if I'll keep the Shane Beavers. There's Buster for the next time I send Big Brother a package. I found some O'Neill Cruises just from Bowman. Here's a 2015 Mookie Betts Bowman card. Some Devers to send to Dave. A lot of Jacob DeGrom and Syndergaard, whatever. There's some Matt Walsh cards. Nothing special. I missed a Shohei Ohtani somehow. It's not like a newer one or valuable one, but. And then here's one with him with Bregman. And there's a team card. Derek Lee rookies, an in-between keeper. A couple of these cards. So I found a couple days ago when the Cubs lost to the Cardinals, I think it was an extra innings. I know that one of the players for the Cardinals, a rookie, Juan Yepes, had a big hit. So I found this, when he was with the Braves, a Juan Yepes Bowman Chrome First. And it sells for like $7-$8. So I put it in the top loader. But that's cool. You never know. Still had a bunch of Bowmans and stuff of players that could still end up being good that I just haven't heard of yet that I left in there. And then, real quick here. Francisco Liriano, pre-rookie card. Edwin Encarnacion was a really good player. Really not a place in my collection for those. I had a big stack of the 2019 Heritage and the regular one, and I got mixed in with 2019 Heritage Miners, and I forgot about that. It was a break that I did with Dave a long time ago. So I found, I said, hey, those are actually the Miners. So just a stack of Miners. The better ones, and like I said, they're like $2 to $5 cards. They're nothing big, but there's an O'Neill Cruz who I collect. I'm actually kind of big on O'Neill Cruz. There's an Ian Anderson, Jazz Chisholm, who's doing really well. He's been a slump lately, and then Colton Welker, who was a player that for the Rockies that I think is gonna be good. So that's all this video is. I'm gonna sort these and put these away. Just these are cards that I had left in there and saved them. Half of them will probably end up going back in the donation pile. But anywho, I'm going to do another video tonight. I think we're getting, I don't know if people are really liking the coin flip stuff, but I think I'm going to do one more coin flip video, one or two more, and see what we get. But I really need an autograph, and you'll see what I mean. I'm going to guarantee that I pull an autograph later on in the video. So from me and Tent Kekulve, wishing you a happy day, and I will see you later. Bye.